So I've been kind of having a pretty good day today, with the exception of me reading another story and bawling my eyes out as usual. Went to lunch with Angela. We had a good time. Came back, got my damn new riding lawnmower running, cut the grass, so that's a plus. Then we laid out the footprint of the addition and we decided it wasn't big enough, so we're gonna go all in and make it bigger. But since I was having such a good day, I've been jonesing to make an arrowhead. This is my rock garden, all the fucking rocks I've eaten on. I said, you know what, go out there and make a damn arrowhead. So I'm gonna try. I haven't napped in a while. But I came over here, but I was gonna sit down and thought you might enjoy, since we just recently talked about Buzzard. This was his headstone. October 87, November of 02. Hit by a car 3 times. Snake bit 2 times. Shot 1 time. Heartworms, 2 surgeries, 89 stitches, 12 dog fights, and I still had to put him down. Goddamn dog. That was an amazing dog. And he just wouldn't give up the ghost. But how are we gonna do this, folks? Let's see. Probably ought to try. I had it and then I screwed it up. Now what have I done? I gotta be the dumbest videographer in the world. Clovis did that. So there was another funny story, not Buzzard. Well, it wasn't funny at all. But this ought to be interesting because I haven't napped in a long time. But I got these 2 pieces of obsidian. Rainbow obsidian. I'm gonna make a knife out of it. I'm gonna make 2 knives. But I don't want to start banging on this right now. I gotta get some muscle memory and some practice back in. Save that for another day. The Buzzard. That dog went with me everywhere. Everywhere that dog went. And I was at a job in Palatine. And he'd already had a reputation. I mean, he bit everybody that came. It didn't matter who it was, he bit them. If they came near my truck, he got bit. So I had to keep him in the truck. I'm doing whatever I'm doing. Well, I didn't know. Somewhere off through the woods was this house. The guy had a pitching heat. The Buzzard could smell it. And what do I want to do?
Anyway, Buzzard can smell it. He jumps high in the window crack. He wiggles his way out of that thing somehow. He goes over there. I guess he's messing with his ritual eat. I don't even know he's gone. I think he's in his own seat. Asleep. Halfway through the bed, I hear this shotgun blast down through the woods. I don't think I ever heard of it because he was talented. By the evening, I go back to the truck, and Buzzard's not there. I look for him in the next morning. I'm driving all around the river, calling and hollering, and can't find him. So I go back the next day, stressed out all night long. And I'm wandering around, calling and looking, and I come up on this guy's house, walk up to the back, and I see this spent shotgun shell. And then I see a little bit of blood here, a little bit of blood there. I was like, that motherfucker shot my dog. I got beat on that door. I'm surprised I didn't get arrested that day. He was in there. He wouldn't come to the door. And I didn't know what to do. I figured he probably shot the dog and hit it somewhere. So I follow the blood trail as best I can. It leads me down into the woods. I go down in the woods and I'm hollering, Buzzard, where are you, Buzzard? I don't know, about 30, 40 yards in the woods, there's this ditch, and I see a little bit of black in that ditch. That man had shot my dog back and down in the woods and just threw it in a ditch. I walk up to it, there's Buzzard. Laying there in this ditch, bleeding or bloody. I said, Buzzard. Nothing happened. I said, Buzzard. His tail went like that. He was so cool. And I swear to God, if that dog had been dead, I scooped him up and I hauled ass to the death. If he'd have been dead, there's a damn real good chance I'd have gone to prison for something. I don't know what. But I scooped him up, took him to the vet. He had 4 buckshot in him. One was right up on his spine. One was in his neck. You could pet him. He made it, obviously. And you could pet him, and that buckshot was lodged right there in his neck, and you could grab it and feel it. The other one went through his stomach, and one went through his liver, I don't know. They stitched him up and he made it. Crazy dog. Anyway, this is probably a dumb idea, but I found these rocks at the heart job. I didn't find them, they were landscaping rocks. And I got to looking at them, and I said, you know, I bet I can make an arrowhead out of it. And it's quartzite. And that is some tough shit to work. I haven't mastered quartzite. I mean, I've got all kinds of guys, flint, sitting, and I got bags of shit. Because I used to flip my all the time. The knife I made. Anyway, but I've never have been able to master quartzite. Because it's just extremely hard to work. right, let's try and see what happens. Got a nice peak. Now see if I had any sense. That's some Georgetown flip. And I know I can make some out of that. But I'm not that smart. I gotta do something harder. That pork chop. Hammerstone. I had this friend, another friend that passed away, Sean Collins. He came back from the first Gulf War, did a job. He started working with me. I told him about Buzzard. He knew about Buzzard. I guess one day he just decided he was gonna make friends with that dog. And I told him, I said, it ain't gonna happen, dude. You may as well not even try it. He said, no, I can make friends with that dog. He and I gonna be buddies. And I had a bad grindstone on this one. Luckies. On a whole box of fried chicken. We sat out there and lunch one day, and you take Buzzard off the chain or away from the truck. It's fine. Lovey dovey, no problems. Right over there by the fire. Sean's over there just feeding Buzzard chicken, talking to him, petting him. He's having a good old time. He's like, I got this dog in the palm of my hand. He's working with him. working with him. And I knew it was going to happen. He gave that dog, half that box of chicken. And then after lunch, whatever, chained the dog to the bumper. And he thought he was going to walk up there and get a saw. And that dog like to hit his ass up. And he was like, what is wrong with that dog? I said, I told you, stay the hell away from that truck. I mean, it was a well-known fact. It wasn't like anyone should be surprised. Because I had to be wearing dog signs all over that truck. But his wife at the time, they got divorced. Man, this ain't. Margaret was her name. We were at the bay. And she knew about Buzzard. And she stayed away from the truck. But what she didn't know was Buzzard was really protective of me, regardless of where I was. And I was out in the marsh or on the beach looking for arrowheads. This is just not it. I'm down low on my hands and knees crawling around in these mud flats. And Margaret is just walking down the beach. And Buzzard is just sitting there guarding me. He knows I'm not paying attention. He's sitting on the mud flat. He sees Margaret coming. And he watches and watches. Watch, and you're walking on the sand, I can't hear her coming. I'm looking for arrowheads. And she thinks she's gonna walk up on me and say, hey, how are you doing? And that damn dog said, you ain't doing that. And he ran out there and hit her right square in the ass. I jerked her pants off. I felt so bad. But just look out for me. I think this might have been a bad idea. Pre-forms, the ones I've already basically flattened out, and all I gotta do is refine them and turn them into something. So I'm on this other job. This is really what Buzzard is really. Young, and I didn't quite know his tendencies. He was Buzzard and Dilly at the time. And Dilly was the bait. She'd sit there and wag and wag and wag, and Buzzard was the bite. he'd hide underneath that back tire until you got until you got close enough. He knew the length of his chain. And he'd come out and bite the shit out of you. And anyway, he's on this. I can't do two things at once, apparently. He's on the chain. Gilly's out there wagging. We're in the driveway. I'm building a porch on his house. And the real estate agent comes up. She's walking down the driveway. I think this is the first time Buzzard did anything. Gilly's out there wagging her tail. She walks up to the Buzzard and starts petting Billy. Buzzard came out of there and bit her right square in the ass too. And I mean bit her good. Ripped her skirt, pantyhose, all that shit. Man, face. I'm going to be in trouble now. And so the superintendent finds out about it. I apologize to the woman and paid for her skirt from pantyhose or whatever the hell that dog chewed up. But it didn't matter. I mean, we made shots and everything. The superintendent found out. What am I doing? He said, dude, you can't have this dog in this neighborhood. Man, I ain't having that. Dog rides me up. Anyway, so he said, you just can't have him on our job site. There was a cul-de-sac. There was a new neighborhood, a cul-de-sac. One of the houses is there. So I go park my truck over there. Walk around the corner, go to the job and work. Everything seemed to be going fine. I came back to the lunch one day. Walking through the truck. Buzzard and Dilly are underneath the truck. And I said, what do you got there? They had something they were chewing on. I gotta focus here a minute. I'm gonna break this chip right on. Tennis shoes, about that big. I knew Bias was in trouble there. It was about the time I found that tennis shoe. I turned around and there was it must have been every damn new family in the neighborhood. They were coming down the street like a mob lynch. Kid was so young, he didn't know how to read it. Beware of dog signs. I tell you, who could get near my truck? It's Tim L. We were framing. It was one of the first houses I started framing. dog rolled out from underneath that truck and bit Tim. Tim turned around and drop kicked that dog. The link was changed. They came to an understanding real quick. Then there was a time. I was springing a house out in Columbia. Way the hell out there. Past Gooch now, man. Too bad or whatever the hell it is. Buzzard was old as dirt. So I didn't have to chain him up anymore. I just let him out, he crawl up under the truck. He'd still bite you, but it's not like he was afraid the dog run all over the place like he used to. And he just laid there and slept. No big deal. I went out to the truck one day. He was gone. I'm gone, dog. I couldn't find that dog. I looked. I figured, you know, they say, you know, dogs, when they think they're going to die, they go off in the woods and they die. And that's where I thought it happened. But I still wanted to find it. I mean, I looked for 2 weeks. Never could find hide in the hair of that dog. I was going around to people's houses and knocking on doors and just see this dog following me. Shit. I didn't find him. Gave me the job one day. Luis. Luis Munoz, my lead guy. He knew I was upset. I mean, we were all upset. We all love Buzzard. And Senor Kevin. I walk up there. He opened the van door. Buzzard was sitting in the back of his van. On a pile of t-shirts. And the Buzzard, he wagged his tail and he hobbled out. He was, I mean, he was all bucked up at him. I said, "Where in the hell did you find him?" He said, "He was on Harriman Broad, walking back to Richmond." They picked him up. I mean, hell, that might have been 30 miles. I mean, it was an hour drive. Hey, that dog got lost, I guess. And he said, "Fuck this, I'm going home." He was just walking down. He was like, anyway, he was going home. They found him. I got him back again. This careful down on these ends. You hit it the wrong way and snap that thing just right in half. Which does happen. Back when I was making all those knives, those pink knives, I was making them out of obsidian and stone, old toilet bowls, TV screens. I was producing those things because they were selling. They would get so frustrated because you. That was before I messed my hand up too. I mean, you could get that knife blade. That knife blade like that. You're just trying to get one or two little flakes, spin it out or something, and hit that thing wrong. You might have an hour and a half in it. Maybe longer. Break up something like that. Brilliant. You're ready to break it right now. What did I just say? I knew it. I'm just sitting here telling you I'm getting ready to break it when I break it. But that's what happens when you don't support freeform property. I'm still trying to get one out of there. Oh, good night. big fluke, and that was a scary one. Trying to thin this thing out. Keeper matters, I should shut the hell up and pay attention to that wheel. got it. One more. I don't break it up. Take a pinning plate there, but I'm scared I'm gonna snap it. I forgot to tell you, by the way, I got busted in the back and got shot. Called animal control and the sheriff's department. They went out there and questioned the guy. Turns out he was a convicted felon and he wasn't supposed to be shooting a gun anyway. They locked his ass up. Searched to find a skill long lost, to acquaint my soul at an inflated cost, and learn the secret within each stone, so refined with love falls a razor home. To know the work of days gone by, and escape our symmetric complacent lives. To feel the loss for potential cracks, gaining wisdom from the gravel step. I'll have confidence knowing I can fashion perfect point through love and passion. It may pierce the heart of any soul and sustain a life that feels no hope. 20 years I've had the stones to awaken my heart from its lack of knowledge. With a perfect point that's still awake, my love grows stronger and never changes.
It's a basket of arrowheads. You can bet your ass every one of them I was making, I was thinking and stressing about something. That was my outlet. All right, Mom. I hope you enjoy your double feature. Till next Sunday.